Hello everyone and welcome. Today I'm going to share some insight about robotic process automation. I'll give you the overview. What is RPA? It's called also robotic process automation. And why you are hearing a lot about RPA these days? What it is? What are the industry RPA can be implemented? As well as type of automation software available in the market? And what is the future of robotics automation? This entire aspect I'm going to cover. Let's begin. First, we need to know that we have to know that what is RPA, robotic process automation, correct? So let me divide this. First, what is robot? Robot is a mechanical form or machine which is programmed for executing certain actions. That is robot in very simple term. What is process? In day-to-day action or activity what we take in a organization or any not only organization, any step you follow some step to do something, that is called process. The entire bunch of steps, that is called process. It may be sending an email, or it may be executing some task that comprise of set of steps. Those entire steps is called process. And what is automation? Automation is like set of task which is programmable and predefined. So it is predefined set of code or instruction which is get executed through program, that is called automation. So combining this all, now we call robotic process automation. Now the next, why you are hearing about lot about. So nowadays, like I will refer that this is not new. Automation is not new. It was already there in the industry, in mechanical industry, in pharmaceutical, in agriculture, it was already there. Some form through which actually we were eliminating the part or action of human, correct? But now it's time to implement the same set of rule in form of programs into the industry or organizations such as IT, BPO and ITES. It's time to automate those industry. This revolution called digitization, and it's impacting like hugely, and all organizations are open to accept this offering. So let me take you through what is the why you are hearing a lot about and what is the reality. Just to let you know, it is all real. It is happening in ground level and it is changing the industry in massive way. As we know about Lean Six Sigma, it is used for improving the process. Now the next level is RPA. Next level is RPA, and it is very huge. Let me give you some prediction of few top analytics firms such as I will refer Forrester as well as HFS and also McKinsey Insight. So according to Forrester, the prediction was that in 2016 this industry would be approx $250 million, but it's already exceeded that benchmark, and it is expected that by 2020 it would be crossing $2.9 billion. It's very huge, correct? At least including artificial intelligence, because the future of robotics is artificial intelligence. It will merge there. So it's huge, and in ground reality I'm telling you what is happening now. Companies are adopting RPA. Earlier in initial stage it is for like one robot, two robot in entire process. Now the demand is, they are asking that 1,000 robot, that the benchmark is 1,000 robot, 2,000 robot, 5,000 robots across industry. That is the benchmark now. So the demand is huge because the benefit is huge. I'll talk about the benefit in this series, that what are the advantage organizations getting, but this is what the reality is. And according to this is about the growth part, and as well as the impact part, according to McKinsey Insight, by 2020 in upcoming 5 years, all across globe, 5 million job will be impacted, let alone in India. It would be approx 1.5 million jobs will be impacted through RPA, artificial intelligence, and smart process automation tools. So it's huge. The market is really big, and you can refer this, and these are real prediction. In ground level, it is happening. You have also heard, just to let you know, based on my live experience, I'm currently engaged on this activity, and I can see it is really, really massive and growing rapidly beyond our imagination. Every organization is putting so much effort into this so that they can scale up their potential and they can really achieve the target they are setting for them, and they can actually compete their competitor in this field. So there are various aspects. This is the reality, just to let you know. Now next is, like, what are the industry where we can where RPA is getting implemented, correct? Just to let you know, this every industry poorly in segmented, wherever computer used or sort of different application getting used, it can be implement, or we can implement RPA there without any challenge at this moment. Okay, poorly, if I say, if you really wanted to categorize, like in HR services, financial accounting, in HR, like payroll related work, onboarding related work, then education and training related work. Similarly, in accounting, it is massive. Upcoming time, accounting and insurance would be completely automated, because it's all rule based. Okay, there are rule based on that. We can program our robots or bots to execute those tasks, and completely it can be eliminated. And now organization has already identified that pattern, and they are doing a lot of research into it. And the objective is that initially they have started with automating the simple processes, as well as there are complex decision based processes that will be covered by machine learning and cognitive capability, as well as the advanced level is artificial intelligence. It is already started across multiple, like, banks in UK, I'm referring, in Japan, it is already being implemented. Okay, so now it's time for us to actually learn those skills, so that we can also prepare and utilize our skills into a real market where it would be really demanding. Okay, so this is, I have just shared a couple of aspect where we can automate in finance and accounting, like sales order related, record to report, order to cash, then inactive claims, train tracking, all this activity. And IT services also can be automated. For example, like Active Directory related actions, FTP, email activation. These are very core tasks or basic tasks, correct? Which any organizations require to execute. They have account department, they have HR department, they have IT department, and these all work, small step of work, whatever I'm just repeating now, these can be completely automated. Okay. And the huge impact is quality. So once we automate any task based on set of rules, the quality is approx like 70-75% get reduced. No need to check that. It is really, really big. So now organizations paid a lot of effort and resources to do QC checks. That can be completely eliminated once RPA is introduced into that particular field. Then, of course, supply chain management, other automation, like for example contact center, call center, chatting services, Excel automation, you just name it. Now we are actually customizing, or the automation software is getting customized to execute each and every kind of work. There is no limitation to it, that this sort of work only can be limited and this can't be, because they are day in, day out, they are doing R&Ds and finding out the ways to automate various processes, as I just name few of them. So again, like retail, hospitality, healthcare, you just name it, procure to pay, government sector, telecom sector, each and every sector, and it's few processes also I have just said, those can be completely automated. Okay, and organizations are putting lot of effort to explore and identify more and more areas where RPA can be introduced. So the scope is really huge. Okay. Next is, so now the reality, you know, what are the industry it will cover. Now, what are the type of software available? Let me take you through one small presentation here. So I have already covered what is RPA. Characteristics, it is saying that it does not require programming skill. Okay, if you have programming, it will be really added advantage, or else with minimum programming understanding, you can start this. There is not as such challenge to understand it. It's very intuitive to learn. Just you have to have that basic understanding of the processes. You will be able to explore it. There will be no challenge. Okay. And RPA works with multiple system environment. This is a very big advantage. I'll take you through that. And RPA works with well-defined rule-based processes. But just to let you know, now they are also exploring the field which is not rule-based with the help of cognitive and machine learning. Okay, repetitive and rule-based transactions can be done. So morally, we look for that where the volume is very high. Those processes qualify for robotic process automation. Correct. What is the benefit here? I have tried to point out a couple of benefit, like it's improved process. Of course, if I have a company and I introduce it, of course, improving my process because I am eliminating the human activity, and that activity I am engaging in, that resource I'm engaging in some more, much more higher value added activity. So it is improving my process. Correct. And reducing FT, of course, cost reduction, increasing efficiency, very, very huge. It increases efficiency. For example, I have 10 resources, and with that 10 resources, I introduce 5 robots. Now I have 15 resources altogether, correct? And it is increasing my efficiency end of the day. The task which can be 24/7, I will put my robot to execute those tasks, and other value-added corely work, which is focused like analysis related work, that can be done by human, and I will engage my human resource to do that. So it will increase my efficiency of my company. Correct. Quick wins, we can really like quick wins, we can do for quick wins means short wins through which we can through one short implementation we save $1 million. Quick wins, very simple. I just eliminated this process, or I automated this process, it gives me this benefit instantly. Correct. Then again, compliance, security related, improving accuracy. I just highlighted already that if I automate this, because human can commit error, but not robots. It's just follow the rules the way you will program it. So it is a huge impact that it will definitely improve your accuracy. It has low risk, and very, very important is that it's called invasive. So the very benefit of RPA is, let's say we have 5-4 application, correct? We no need to change those application. Let's say our process get changed. We no need to change those application. My RPA or my RPA have that infrastructure that it will adopt those changes. And based on that, we can customize our programs. So I no need to put effort or money into changing that entire infrastructure. Rather, I need to focus on just customizing my task or bot. That is very big. That's the very big advantage of RPA. Correct. This is what I am highlighting here. No changes in the system, as you can see. No changes in the system. Okay. So say like this. These are the few, and based on your creativity, you can put in on different horizon. You can put in multiple other benefits as well. Okay, but these are the core, and another is scalability. Correct. Let's say I have resources, 10 people receive suddenly I receive one business and I need 20 people to execute those tasks. So I just have to increase the number of bots, and I did that task can be executed. Correct. So that is very, very huge advantage of RPA. So I can overnight. So I have one robot which is absolutely configured to execute the task. Now the volume has increased. Just I need to overnight increase that robot numbers and deploy those programs into it, and just done. You are ready to work from the next day. Not even next day, on the fly, if you able to arrange that, it can be done instantly. So these are the few benefits of RPA. Okay. The next is like what is the future of RPA? See, there are multiple aspect which is now influencing this industry, but name of them is like, initially we started with manual execution, then currently we are in the second stage which is called RPA, and even few industry which they have already reached the stage called autonomics or platform, which what we cover, let's say, let me cover in RPA, what we cover is standardized and repeatable task. We automate the standardized and repeatable task. But in autonomics, which is called smart automation, also it's called intelligence automation, through that we automate the complex and standard work, correct, processes. I'm referring processes here. And then the next level is cognitive computing, where we execute non-standard contextual and interface. Contextual interface, we do it. We execute our task through that interface. That is, in nature of it is not standard. It is, there is no fixed standard of the input information what we receive. But those activity can be automated with the help of cognitive. And then final stage is artificial intelligence, which is the combination of complex, standard, non-standard, as well as it's learn itself. That is artificial intelligence. That's the highest stage. Even lots of company, big five, I will rather say, big five company already investing a lot of effort to improving this area. Google, Facebook, Amazon, Microsoft, Apple, they are already investing a lot of effort to improve this area. And already the software which is available based on robotics, they have already reached the cognitive computing capability. They have already achieved that level. Okay. So this is the future where we are going ahead at this moment in the at present. And what are the tools available at this moment in the market to actually meet this requirement, meet the industry requirement, and actually make this journey very easier? Just to let you know, there is huge competition in terms of vendors who provide RPA platforms. There are multiple, I'll name a few, like Blue Prism, Automation Anywhere, UiPath, correct, WorkFusion. But leading here is, in my view, all the tool have the similar capability, but which gives more flexibility that and more flexibility in terms of adopting that tool, and more flexibility while developing a task, more flexibility while increasing the number of robots, that tool will lead, correct? More of the core important should goes to that flexibility of how it can be learned, as well as the flexibility to develop complex task. So now in my preference, of course, the leading tool is Automation Anywhere. It's leading at this moment, and I'll share you why it is leading. I'll share some insight about that aspect. Okay, moving to the next, I have just wanted to give an overview that what qualifies an RPA. So let's say I wanted to deploy a RPA, or I wanted to scan a project whether that is eligible for robotic process automation or not. How would I know that? So for that, first criteria is data should be digital. I can't do any manual activity, correct? I have to write something, I have to make an entry in a book. That is not digital. I can't automate that. Next is, it should be rule based. The volume should be high. Let's say, what is rule based? It should be fixed rule. Okay, so I have received a mail from specific user, and if I receive a mail from that specific user, I have to do this activity. So that is a specific rule, correct? So it should be rule based. If else command, okay, if this, else this, then execute this task, correct? And then action, I rather say. Third criteria is the volume should be really high. So if any process, there is volume is, let's say, 10, 20, or it's not significant, that process will not at all qualify for RPA, correct? Then again, it should be fixed UI. If day to day I am changing my system application, it's not qualify for RPA. It would not be, we will not be automate that process. stable and standard process. So stable means it should be like standard. For example, every day the same pattern we should follow. So every next day, if the standard and process get changed or update get changed of that process, it would be complex to implement RPA. But it's not far away those days where we can also adopt on that scenario as well. That's not much far, I will rather say, based on my current experience, what I am experiencing in learning in this industry. That's not far away. But yeah, currently this is one limitation. Repetitive in nature. What we repeat, let's say it is for limited edition. Let's say I have to just execute 500 transactions. It's limited, correct? I can't, there is no requirement to do that. It should be repeated in nature, lifetime. For example, verification process, data entry, and rather statement generation. This is repetitive. Every month we have to do this, correct? So the process should be in that nature. Next is manual intervention. It should have some manual intervention where human intervenes something. Then it qualifies for RPA. Or else if it is, there is no intervention, it is already automated, it is already digitized, that it doesn't qualify. Skilled resource, of course, this is the sub requirement I'll rather classify it as. Skilled resource required, or else how you will be like able to do that entire. But this is absolutely different aspect, but I have also added because this is also qualify for RPA. If it is not there, how you will actually build that entire process to implement robotics. So these are the things. If you have your process is qualified to do RPA, you will be able to execute it. Or else if you don't have, you have to gather these resources to deploy RPA in your process. Next, I have just tried to give one small demo here, that case study rather. What is happening here, I'll just explain it. So there is this is one process. So in this process, emails comes into a mailbox and user, this is human icon, you can see this. So user reads those mailbox, then he takes a decision based on that. Let's say the contained mail is more than 5 or more than equal to 5, then based on that he's classifying whether it is simple or complex. So decision is there, then he's classifying that, and then he's, after classification, he is processing that and classifying again, the second level classification happening, whether it is level 1 query or level 2 query, and then it is getting again processed. Based on that, they are categorizing that, whether that they are taking that decision that whether level 1 process is already done or not, or level 2 response is received or not. Based on that, they are categorizing as that task is completed or task is still pending, and that process get ended. This entire process, the highlighting point is, let's say this is a normal process, you can refer in other process also same. So there are some step, some decision, then there is some action, and then again updation, system updation, then again action, then categorization. So this entire steps a comprise or example of a process where in multiple step human intervention included. So this human intervention, what is happening, the challenge here is, first challenge is, of course, it is manual in nature. Then the challenge is doing this activity, it is taking time to do it, reconcile and calculations is taking time to execute that, correct, to validate that, taking that decision. Visibility is not there. If let's say I do so, or user commit some error, we will be not able to visualize that. We have to actually be very conscious while executing that task. We don't have visibility until a QC checks that product, end product. Then first is, of course, accuracy. There is no guarantee how much accurate it would be. But if I deploy a robo, let's see how it will be converted. So if we deploy robots, see, these are the automated now. These are the steps which is automated. So reading mail can be done by a program, and then it can search the keyword. Then it can classify that, and then again it can read that specific keyword, and then again it can classify it, and then it can also categorize it, update the status. So this entire process can be done very quickly. Let's say the previous process take approx 5 minutes. Here it can be done in less than 1 minute. Just I'm giving an example number, it's not fixed, it's depending on the program and complexity, but it will drastically change the timing for sure. So this is how this is a basic example I've given that what was manually and what was the challenges and how we deploy the robots here. These are called bots, and then this entire process get reduced and executed very quickly. And what is in terms, what result we are getting is, of course, it is increasing the efficiency, reducing the FT, because let's say the entire activity in 8 hours, user used to process 100 mails. Now robot can work 24/7. Of course, it will reduce the FT, correct? Improving transparency of work. I know what is going on because every step is getting logged. I will be able to identify it. And then improving customer experience. End of the day, if I process more emails, I will satisfy my customer. And that process is not normal. It is accurate processing, correct? Because I have fixed a few rules, and based on that, it is processing. So this is how actually it is helping customer, and end result how it becomes like, it reduces AHT, of course. Accuracy is of course 100%, because I have fixed the rule. If that rule will not match by robots, it will throw some exception and that can be taken care of. But at least it will not commit any error. It is 100% accurate, and it will also reduce the FT. This is the benefit we get. This is a small case study I've given how actually we implement. So there is as is process, then we implement it, then that is to be, and then we calculate it, then we get the value. This is the how RPA process looks like and how we get the benefit out of it.
Hope this has helped you to understand what is robotic process automation is, why you are hearing a lot about it, what it is, and what are the different tools available in the market. And the end note would be that as you are hearing a lot, we should improve our skill set so that we can stay relevant to the market demand, market need. Okay, so hope this entire session actually help you to get a direction towards it. Thank you for investing your time and being with me. Have an amazing day. Thank you.